I am Ola Onsrud, and I am reenacting a 14th century knight from Northern Europe. In my last video, I talked about the surcoat you wear over the harness. In this video, I will show you how I made the surcoat I'm wearing now. So welcome to my workshop, where I make and maintain my clothes and equipment. So where do I start making my surcoat? Well, looking at available historical sources is always a good start. The best preserved surcoat from the 14th century used over harness is the Black Prince's surcoat or jupon. Some years ago, I had the opportunity to visit the Canterbury Cathedral and see both the prince's effigy and his belongings, including his jupon or surcoat. Conservation work has shown that the jupon was worn by the prince during his lifetime, and it's made of a thick linen with wool padding. On the outside, it's added silk panels in alternating red and blue, where the heraldic lines of England and the fleur-de-lis of France is applied. When put on, it is closed with a lacing passed through eyelets in the front. The jupon appears to be half-sleeved. The effigy of the Black Prince, however, shows him wearing a sleeveless garment with daggins. Since I like daggins, I have decided to make daggins on my surcoat. Good basic patterns for 14th century jupons or surcoats are available. Since I made several of these surcoats earlier, I already have a pattern fitting my size and my armor. I start with cutting out the parts for the outer silk panels, which I reinforce with a linen underlining. With 8 panels ready for the torso, I cut out the heraldic symbols from silk. To make them easier to handle, I cheat and put on an interfacing. Then the time-consuming task to apply them to the surcoat begins. Finally, I have 8 panels with heraldic ready. The 4 parts that will make up the arms I will do later. Now I stitch each upper and lower panel together. It's time to control the size, so I pin all the finished parts together to try it on and adjust it to my harness. Do not forget seam allowance for the lining and space for the padding. The time has come for the lining. 2 layers of linen sewn to each of the 4 parts. This includes making the daggins. I will make them with square and not rounded edges as on the Black Prince's effigy. Before cutting, I have made 1 seam on each side. To prevent the seams to crack when I turn the fabric inside out, I reinforce with extra stitches. Be cautious when you do this, and the result will be very nice. In contrast to the Black Prince's jupon, I will use mostly linen with some wool for padding. The padding will be made up by 1 solid part of 8 layers of linen and wool, and additional stripes of cloth filled in the vertical channels I will make next. To make the seams of the vertical channels to follow the shape of the surcoat, I always draw them first. I sew the channels in the front and back. I fill them with strips of linen 6 layers thick. The 2 back pieces are stitched together, and then the front parts are stitched to this at the shoulders.
After making the eyelets for the lacing on the front, it's time to try it on for a final adjustment before closing the sides. I make the half sleeves the same way I made the front and the back parts. Be sure that the borders between black and white adds up. Now let's compare the result with the black prints original. The finished surcoat weighs 2.7 kilograms.